going to determine the derivative of each function using the power rule stated here. The derivative of x to the power of n is equal to n times x to the power of n minus 1. So for this first function, it doesn't seem to fit the form of the power rule. So we do have to write this to fit the form of the power rule. If we move this x to the third up into the numerator, it'll change the sign of the exponent. So this function is the same as f of x equals 4x to the power of negative 3. And now it does fit the form of the power rule, so we can use it to find the derivative. So f prime of x is going to be equal to 4 times the derivative of x to the power of negative 3. So we're going to multiply by our exponent, that's negative 3. And then we're going to subtract 1 for the new exponent. So we're going to have negative 12, and this will be x to the power of negative 4. And then we'll go ahead and rewrite this as a positive exponent by moving it back down to the denominator. Moving it back down will make this exponent positive 4. So our derivative is going to be equal to negative 12 all over x to the positive 4 power. And sometimes we're given an exponent that's in decimal form, but that doesn't change how we apply the power rule. So we have f prime of x is going to be equal to negative 12 times the derivative of x to the power of 0.25. So we'll multiply by the exponent, and then we'll subtract 1 to get the new exponent. So let's go ahead and simplify this. Negative 12 times 0.25, that's going to be negative 3. And our exponent is 0.25 minus 1, that's going to be negative 0.75. And normally if the original exponent is in decimal form, we can leave the exponent in decimal form. But if we did want our exponent to be positive, we would have to move it down to the denominator. So our final derivative would be negative. Notice how the 3 stays in the numerator, and we're only moving down the x part. So we'd have x to the positive 0.75 in the denominator. In the next video, we'll take a look at determining derivatives using the power rule when the function is given in radical form.